Several things need to be considered here. Okay, let me see. Let me take that in. Right. So here you see load device is subject to substrate bias limit. That is important. So active pull-up device here, its source voltage, as you can see, it's not grounded. It's higher up. So the source to body voltage will be some positive value, and hence this the VTL, that means the threshold voltage of this pull-up device will no longer be zero bias threshold voltage VTO, but we should apply a generalized expression for the threshold voltage of the pull-up device. That is equal to into root over k absolute value to phi, where phi is the electrostatic Fermi potential of the p substrate of this device, and plus root over 2 phi. Okay, right. Now for small output voltage, that means when output voltage is small, you can show that the load transistor will be in saturation. Why? Because obviously VDS load is greater than VGS load minus VT load. And here you can see that this will indeed be the saturation. That means Vout voltage, if it is quite low, that means it is lower than the sum of power supply voltage plus VT load. But remember, VT load is negative for this depletion mode load device. Hence, overall, this will be a positive number, and magnitude-wise, it will be somewhat lower than VDD. Okay, it is clear? So long as output voltage is lower than this limit, the upper transistor, that means the pull-up load device, will be in saturation. Okay, right? And, based on the input voltage, we can have different regions of operation of the pull-down device. That we shall see. Okay? And the saturation load current we can apply, remembering that this will be in saturation, so it will be kn load by 2 into VT load rho square. Now for large output voltage, of course, that means the drain to source voltage of this pull-up device is smaller, so hence the pull-up load will be in linear region. Okay, right? Okay, obviously, because VGS minus VT load minus this, it will be a positive number because VT load is a negative value. So long as Vout is greater than VD plus VD load, it will be the that will be possible if a high output voltage is there. So obviously for this, the active the pull-up load will be in linear region. Okay. Now you see in more details, if you consider this typical voltage transfer characteristic of this device, right? So So what do you get? In the adjacent VTC for depletion load inverter. For VOL, the input voltage is quite high, and VOL is quite small. And at this point of operation, the driver voltage can be the driver operating region. Okay, obviously it will be the input voltage is equal to VL. This is desired that when this inverter drives a similar inverter, when the output voltage is at VOL, the second inverter should be in cutoff. Okay, so input voltage being VOL, output voltage is of course equal to VOH, and the driver transistor is in cutoff. And load operating region, the load device operating region will be linear. And if you gradually increase, it is becoming VIL equal to input voltage equal to VIL. The output voltage is, of course, not exactly equal to VOH, but slightly lower than VOH, almost equal to VOH. And we have seen that for high output voltage, the upper transistor is in saturation and lower transistor is, when input voltage is VIN, okay, so upper transistor is in linear region, okay, because this high value, so high value output means the VDS equal to small, right? So VDS equal to small for the upper transistor. So upper transistor will be linear and lower transistor will be in saturation. And as you gradually increase for VIH, output voltage is quite small. So output voltage quite small means the load device is in saturation, as you have seen, and the driver transistor is linear. And when VOH equal to VOL, okay, when VIN equal to VO is quite high, output voltage is low, the load device in saturation and driver region is linear. So operating regions and voltage levels of driver and load transistor at critical points we have shown. Now let us consider how to calculate this. As before, you see, okay, so far if you have got any doubt, you can, question, I, yeah. So if, any question? Okay, I believe all of you and all of you are able to see it, no? If any doubt, let me know. Okay,
I think you have explained, but actually I have not still clear this why one transistor is enhancement and why one is depletion, or why not it is both in depletion or both is in enhancement.
Okay, that we have discussed earlier. The typical choice is that, you see, if you keep a transistor, for one thing, let me explain that when you have a depletion mode load device, it provides you with a transistor which is always on. That means always it will provide a channel. But at the same point of time, you have to think of the fabrication aspect. That means you need to have a ion implantation process in place. Okay, that means so that you can provide a channel even though gate to source voltage is low. So fabrication wise, the cost will increase. That will increase the overhead. But at the same point of time, what benefit it gives you is that always it will provide you a channel. And its size can be kept minimum. That also you need to consider. Whenever you have a depletion mode load device, if its purpose is just to provide a constantly on switch, you can mimic it as a constantly on, what you call, channel, the constantly on switch type of
transistor.
Okay, transistor, yeah. So that means if that is the purpose, then it need not provide a, what you call, high current driving ability. It need not drive any device, any load. Then we can have the smallest size, smallest aspect ratio. That means you can have the feature size device. That means a 2 lambda is the length, 2 lambda is the width. Okay. So how else it will be useful for us? However, for the driver transistor, you see, the driver should go through, normally when you are incrementing the input voltage starting from the absolutely zero value and going up to power supply, okay, gradually it is increasing, then it is required to have a device which will provide you through all the regions, namely cutoff, then saturation, then linear. For that, the driver needs to be enhancement mode. So driver device, you will find whether you are using NMOS and PMOS, always to be enhancement mode device. Hardly ever you will find a what you call a depletion mode device. Because depletion mode device, okay, if you use a NMOS transistor, its threshold voltage is negative. But however, for all practical purpose, we never use a, what you call, unless it is absolutely necessary, the input voltage range is always positive. It starts from zero overall. But however, if you have a driver which is always on, it may not serve the purpose. For some point of time, you need to have a driver which is cut off. Okay, right. So that the next state also, I mean, it will be depending on that. So if it is cut off, in the next state, it will be on. So off, on, off, on. Normally we have this combination for different purpose, right? Inverter is a very important element of the digital design. So for that, the driver design, driver device needs to be a enhancement mode device. Now, we have discussed that as regards the pull-up device, we have got different choices. We can have a saturation transistor. So using a saturation transistor is that it will have a limited VOH. So noise margin is limited. Also, the current is quite high. Okay, so if you used to, if you want to do away with that, increase the noise margin, then you can replace the saturated enhancement mode active load by a linear enhancement mode load. Okay, but what will be the problem? The problem will be that you have to bring in another power supply. Okay, so that the VOH can be enhanced to perfect power supply is a VDD. BGG is an additional power supply, mind you. So need to provide it all will also add to the cost, and power supply cost is quite sizable. When you're talking in a typical design, okay, see, fabricating another transistor now in the realm of a very highly developed fabrication technology, it will not much add to the cost, but having to bring in a power supply, that will lead to a considerable cost. So this, so that that's why this is not what you call adopted. OK, Okay, at some point you may find it present, but normally in general, having a saturated enhancement mode transistor or linear enhancement mode transistor is not much adopted because of the fact that this will lead to a high DC power dissipation. On the other hand, if you keep a depletion mode device, only some fabrication cost overhead will increase because you have to provide a channel, ion implanted channel. But taking everything into consideration, this will lead to least amount of power dissipation possible amongst the three choices. Okay, right? And also area occupation is quite small by this depletion mode device compared to other enhancement tools. So that's why people go for this third variety. That means having a depletion mode device as active load. Okay, got it, Punandu?
Yes, now, thank you.
So next what we are doing, this is very important. You see, that means how to solve for different output voltage values, and later we shall see their limited numerical values. So here, all of you please pay attention. Here we see, do not ever forget this important equation. That means here you see the threshold voltage of the pull-up load is a function of the output voltage of the overall inverter. That please do not forget, right? So because threshold voltage of this active pull-up device is always a function of output voltage. So this we need to take into consideration why we are solving for different algebraic expression as well as numerical expression for the salient voltages. So as before, for calculating VOL, we know that VOL is quite small a value, and for that the VOL is quite small means you see that the drain to source voltage of this device is quite large, right? Because VDS of upper load transistor and VDS of pull down driver transistor gives me the total power supply. So if the output voltage is high, VOL is quite low, so hence VDS is quite high, and obviously we can guess that the active pull up device is in saturation. So hence we can write the current voltage equation like this. So lower device, that means the pull down driver is in linear, the pull up active load is in saturation. Okay, so if you write this expression, next what you do, just to get a straightforward what do you call, by solving this quadratic in VOL. Okay, remembering the fact that the threshold voltage is a function of output voltage, for the timing, if you neglect dependence of VT load on VOL, we get this out of solving the quadratic equation, right? Here the discriminant is VH minus VT whole square. So this is a very important expression. That means the output, nominal output low value is nominal output high minus VTO. This corresponds to the threshold voltage of the lower pull down transistor. Okay. And then root over VH minus VT whole square minus this K ratio. Okay. K ratio of the load and driver. That is a very important factor, as you shall see later. And VT load whole square. But let me tell you that when you are going to solve the numerical value for VOL, okay, at one go, it may not be possible to get the correct value. Why? You know, actual value of the low output voltage will involve some numerical iteration. So it is found by solving the two equations, equation 5 and equation 1 also. That we should not forget. Okay, right. So as you shall see that in the first, as a first guess, okay, output voltage is taken to be 0, and you find out the threshold voltage of the upper device, okay, actual value, then put that into this equation, you get it like that. So a few iterations may be necessary before which you get the final stable value of the output voltage. That we shall see later. Remember, that means in order to find numerically the value of VOL or the nominal low output voltage, we need some, what do you call, iterative procedure. That means at one go, one step, we may not get the solution. It will involve equation 5 and equation 1. Okay, both of these. That's why we have written this in boldface. Okay, so equation 1, equation 5 together will lead us towards the solution, numerical solution for VOL. Right? Next, let us say VIL. VIL means the driver in saturation, load is linearity. Okay, because typically high value of output voltage. Then we apply KCL at the output node as before. Okay, we get this. Then differentiate this equation with respect to the input voltage and setting dv out in equal to minus 1, we get this. Okay, so that is sure. But how to get numerically the value for this? Remember, dear friends, that yes, the output voltage and VIL at one go we could have done if the threshold voltage of this device was not a function of output voltage. But now we know for sure that the threshold voltage of the pull-up device happens to be a function of the output voltage. So for numerical solution of VIL, again, you will need to rely on not to these two equations, but also the equation one. So equation one, I request you to remember. Okay, so this is very important equation in the as it is for the purpose of finding the numerical value of the salient voltages. So here it is an involvement of equation one, then equation six and equation eight. So all these three equations together will allow us to get a proper value for VIL. Note that here we have done some approximation. Perhaps you have noted. But let me just just draw your attention to the fact that here what we are doing, okay, we assume dBt load dBin to be equal to negligible. So here, that means this term vanishes. Now, why do we do that? If you ask me the question, I can answer you in this fashion. That means, you see, look at the VTC, how it is carved out, how we are arriving at this. So we start from very low value input voltage. Now, as we proceed towards VIL, note that the output voltage variation is quite small. That means it is almost, that means I draw your attention to this fact, that means from the very small value of input voltage, you are proceeding towards VIL. So you see that the output voltage variation is quite small, right? So the threshold voltage of the lower device, okay, the threshold voltage of the upper device is a function of output voltage. Again, output voltage is a function of input voltage. So dBt, that means dBt load dBin equal to, you can write dBt load dB out multiplied by dB out dB. So dB out dB is quite small, right? Hence, the value we can neglect. That means dBt load dB we can neglect because of the fact that dB out dB equal to negligible, right? So this is one approximation you can say. Okay, so that's why we can get the straightforward solution involving equation 6, equation 8, and equation 1. Next, you see, now your strategy will be somewhat different when you take into account VIH. So as the output voltage is relatively small, driver is linear and load is saturated, that we have seen earlier. Okay. Now, this is, as before, we are going. Here, you see, this is the expression for VIH in terms of, say, zero bias threshold voltage of the driver, output voltage, K load. Again, the K load of K driver ratio is very important. And then this output voltage. And also now you see, we are involved with the slope of, that is dBt load, dB out. This we are not neglecting. You know why? Acha, look at this expression, VT load equal to VTO load. So then we get an expression for dBt load, dB out. This we normally do not tend to neglect. That means now a numerical solution of VIH will involve not only equation 9, equation 11, and equation 1 as before, but equation 12 also. So four equations are involving. The reason is that, again, you see that when you're progressing towards VIH, normally the slope of this is quite large. That means dV out dV in is quite large. It cannot be negligible. So hence, when you're trying to find out dBt load dV out, okay, it is not negligible, right? Because output voltage is varying quite a bit. Note that this is a very sharp slope. Okay, and normally we are looking into the trend. That means we are we are increasing input voltage, starting from the zero value, going towards the power supply voltage. So that's why we are not neglecting. We have done it for the earlier case when comparing VIL, calculating VIL, but now we will not neglect. So I believe all of you have got it, that why the four equations are involved for calculating VIH. Equation 9, equation 11 for solving simultaneously output voltage and in this VIH, okay. Next, you take into account, while doing that, you take into account this variation because you need to have a value for this, okay. Again, note that sure, VT load will also need to be updated, okay, because VT load is a value, is dependent on the output voltage. Achha. Now, see an in-depth evaluation of this K driver to K load ratio. Why is it important? So as before, you see KR means the K driver by K load. So here you see, as before, in the last day, we discussed that L by W ratio of an NMOS transistor is proportional to the impedance offered by the transistor. Hence, KR ratio is a roughly we can say it is primarily proportional to the ratio of the pull up resistance of the and the pull down resistance. Okay, so Z load by Z driver, Z PU by Z PD. PU PD for pull up and pull down, and pull up means a load device, driver transistor is a pull down device, so hence we can write it. So as before, you see that if you increase KRS, suppose if you have designed it to 5, now if you want to increase it to 10, how you can do that? Either you can keep the numerator fixed, decrease the denominator, and if you decrease the denominator, then what will be happening? For the same value of input voltage, now the driver transistor will be able to conduct more amount of current, and more amount of current means it will be able to pull down the output node, okay, for a smaller value of input voltage. So you see that the car will get down, but for a relatively lower value of input voltage. So hence the BTC car will shift leftward, and it will give rise to lower value of the switching inverter threshold voltage also, as you can easily see, right? So it's a very simple explanation, as you can see. And similarly, if you want to decrease the value, how you can do that? Decrease the value is possible if you increase the denominator, or you can decrease the numerator. Decrease the numerator means you are decreasing the impedance offered by the pull-up device. Pull-up device means, why is it called pull-up? Because its job is to pull up the output voltage. When we can pull up the output voltage? When we are decreasing the input voltage from a very high one. So then it is the job of the pull-up device. So for a lower impedance offered by the pull-up device, it will be easier to do that if you are decreasing the input voltage from high value, for smaller change, the output voltage can reach the higher value, right? So it is easier to see that with the decreasing value of KR ratio, the car will shift towards the right, and also thereby it will produce a higher value of inverter switching threshold voltage. Clear? Okay, I believe it is clear. Achha. Next, what you see, as before, we are involved with the design of the inverter. So hence, when we are involved with the design of the depletion mode load inverter, what are the important parameters? Threshold voltage is definitely important, but their technology threshold voltage, right? So they are fixed by the technology. And the power supply voltage is also a design parameter. More importantly, WL ratio of the driver and load, they will tend to exert their influence on the value of the VOL and other parameters. So let me now discuss about what role they play, WL ratio, on the design aspect. Now you see, several salient voltages, VOL, VOH, VIL, VIH, VDD determines the output high voltage, right? But of the remaining three critical voltage, we take VOL as if it assumes a important place. Why is it so? Because it will involve the smallest amount of computation, right? Amongst the VOL, VIH, and VIL. And if we can fix up the WL ratio of driver and load based on VOL, normally as the specification, you will find that for a inverter, it is given that you have to design the inverter based on the targeted specification of VOL value. Why? Because in order to satisfy the VOL value, whatever value of WL ratio the designer has to choose, that will in turn determine the input. Yes, any question? Mukul, any question?
No, sir.
Ayush. Yeah, please. Let me hear. Ayush. Any question, Ayush? Hello? Yeah, Ayush. If you have.
No, sir.
It's there. Hello?
Clear, sir.
Hello?
Okay, okay.
Hello,
sir. Yeah. Okay, thank you. Thank you for your attention. Yeah, so that means VOL.
Sir, I'm here.
Yeah. Yeah, any question?
No, sir. Actually, my mother was calling me for some.
Okay, okay, yeah. Anyway, okay, sure. Yeah, so the problem is that when VOL, we try to determine, okay, based on, see, that means normally the design problem is like that. It is a targeted value will be given, and you are supposed to come up with a suitable WIL ratio of the driver and load transistor in order to meet that value. So how will you do that? Normally, you see, this is the design equation. What you have done, you have simply rewritten the expression which was necessary for solving the value of VOL. You remember that current voltage expression at the output node, okay, corresponding to VOL, okay. So VOL means smaller value of output voltage, and smaller value of output voltage means the load device is in saturation, and the pull-down driver transistor is in linear region. So having solved this, you find that this will be the expression if KR, it will depend on the VT load value, VOH value, VTO value, VOL value. Now for a targeted value of VOL, you can have the value say 0.2 volt. Then you put 0.2, VOH also suppose 5 volt, you know, VTO equal to 1 volt. And as far as the VT load is concerned, you know, there is some fast guess we can make. So suppose it is equal to minus 2.5 or minus 3 volt. For that, some guesses, is it possible? Because you know that VT load equal to VT0 plus gamma into root over 2 phi A plus V out. For that V out, if you put V out, then a first estimate of the threshold voltage is also possible, right? So anyway, for that, you get the value of KR. Okay. Otherwise, what you can do, you can with this particular value of KR, again, if you resolve this, and then it is possible. See, numerical iteration is a very good exercise that is available to us as engineers to arrive at a solution. Okay, even though we may not have the what you call the what is called closed form or direct solution, if it is not possible through numerical iteration, we can have a stabilized value for any parameter. So for here also KR, it is possible to have. So anyway, why we discuss this equation 12, because you see that driver, K driver by K load, mean it is nothing but WIL by driver upon WIL of the load. MUL and COX, that is fixed for both driver and the pull-up device, right? So to indicate the driver to load ratio KR that achieves the target VL value, assuming that VDD, VTO are set previously, okay, also you have got a good estimate for VT load. So we can find out KR, what should be the value. Remember, here it does not throw a pointer to the actual value of W by L, but it is merely the ratio of the width of the driver and width of the load. Again, the channel length of all the transistors is normally kept at the lowest value possible, 2 lambda. Okay, because L, higher you make L, it will increase the impedance of the transistors. So normally the channel length is kept to be minimum value, that is 2 lambda. Okay, so here, for example, for 180 nanometer, you keep it to be 0.2 micrometer or 200 nanometer and so on, right? So this driver to load ratio and their WIL ratio is very important. Note the design procedure determines ratio, not the actual value. The actual value will be depending on other parameters like say current drive ability. That means suppose you remember, say you require say 5 milliampere for the pull-up device or 5 milliampere for the pull-down device. That will lead you to the actual value of the width. Or say even transient switching speed, as we shall see later. So if the output capacitive load is given to us, then from the specification of say T pull up, that means pull up time, we can find out the value for the W width required for the drive, for the load device, or from the specified pull down time, okay, we can get the W of the driver device and so on. That we shall see later. Now you see the brief discussion on power and area consideration. You see, power as before, this is well known to you that assuming that 50% of the time the input voltage is lower side when the driver transistor is off, and for the remaining half it is on. Okay, so then if it is on, that both driver and transistor will conduct significant amount of current. And VOL equal to small value, so that means pull-up device in saturation, pull-down is linear. That also you have seen. So this will be the expression, okay, and the DC power dissipation we can find. Very simple, okay. As far as the, sorry, As far as the area is concerned, dear friend, again, let me take you to what you call this layout diagram. Layout diagram, please give importance to drawing of layout diagram. You will be asked in the examination also. So please pay your attention to the layout diagram. And for your reference, I have drawn the transistor diagram just to have a one-to-one correspondence. So pull-down device, you see, is an enhancement of transistor. So this is the layout for metal, and this is a contact card for. See, that means this is actually what you call the filled up square, small square always shows, or if we show a filled up circle, that also will be able to represent a contact card. Contact card means the metal layer and the diffusion layer, source and drain for the driver device, that means the enhancement mode transistor. Okay, so the source diffusion to have a contact or intentional contact between source diffusion and the metal ground. So you need this contact. Okay, and this is the you show by rectangle with this shaded. So this will portray a metal layer, and both here and this is for the VDD power supply. And this is a polysilicon layer. There is a rectangle with dotted line, and also within that you draw small circles just to show this is a polysilicon layer. And this yellow color, it is to show a yellow color means the ion implant. Okay, ion implant, right? So normally the yellow color, that's why the transistor is called a yellow transistor. You must have heard about the term yellow transistor. Yellow transistor means always remember that this is a depletion mode load transistor. Because of the fact that in polychromatic coding for all the devices, conducting layers, metal, polysilicon, diffusion, then P diffusion, then what you call ion implant, yellow color is very, is a conventional color for showing the ion implant. Okay, ion implant means that is showing the channel for depletion mode device. Here also it should be very, what you call, thickly drawn this line to show that the channel exists, although gate to source is shorted. That means VGS equal to zero, but there is a channel, and hence the threshold voltage is negative. So I think all of you can understand, and you see that the length to W ratio of the pull-up device is higher compared to this length to W ratio. Lower is the L by W ratio. See, driver means driver device should have a impedance lower than the load device, naturally, because driver means it should determine the output voltage. When the driver is slipping, that means driver is inactive, it is no channel here, then only the load device plays the role of keeping the output voltage high. That's why it is called pull-up load device. But otherwise, the driver will determine what should be the output voltage, whether small, whether large, that will be driven by that's why it is called the driver. It should drive the output voltage. Okay. So here, the impedance offered by driver should be as small as possible. So length is small, W is large. So L by W means the conductance. Okay. In reverse of reciprocal of impedance. However, this should provide a high impedance. That's why the length to W ratio is high. So length, that means the length of provided by length of the depletion mode device is higher. Normally it is 4:1. This is 1:1, 1:4 or something like that, right? Adjacent figure shows a simplified layout depletion mode device. But you see that you have to accommodate no less than 4 number of contact cards, and contact cards also take up a lot of space. Contact cut means you etch out some portion and pour metal so that a firm contact is established between diffusion metal. You see, we are showing a two-dimensional curve, but see, actual it is a three-dimensional curve, a three-dimensional plot, a three-dimensional figure. No, metal is on the topmost layer. Under that, you have got the diffusion. Okay. Here also, polysilicon is on top of diffusion. There is no contact between the polysilicon gate and the underlying channel, right? All of you know that. Okay. So here also, when you put the contact cut while it is required, here to make a contact between the drain of the pull-up device and the metal VDD, which conducts power supply. These contact cuts are required because we need to take the output and drive and transfer it to some other place. That's why this metal contact is required. Contact between metal and diffusion here, and here between metal and polysilicon. Okay, because polysilicon gate VGS is shorted. Okay, but this having to accommodate this contact cut take up a lot of space. For that, so why people can go for an alternative design? design means in terms of fabrication. Here, you see, this, what is the difference between this and this? You see, the area occupied by the second, what you call the layout is smaller compared to that. Why? Because you have removed the contact cut. You have done away with the contact cut. Instead, what you have gone for, you have done some buried contact. Buried contact means, as you can see, through this cross-hatched region, these are called butting contact. That means there is no direct contact between the underlying the involvement of metal is unavoidable, but here there is no metal layer to take the output. Okay, the output you can take by whenever it is necessary. Okay, of course it will be necessary. The output you can take from, you can have a thin strip of metal, or through diffusion you can take. Okay, it is not shown. That means how far it will be actually possible to take a good output, I'm not sure. But this is just a means to reduce the area. That means whenever these metal contact cuts are done away with, it is avoided, you can go for a buried contact. That means buried contact means what? On top, you have got the polysilicon layer, you etch it. Etch it means you remove some of the polysilicon through some hydrochloric acid or whatever, then dig it. Dig and pour metal. Okay, if you do that, what you have got? This polysilicon, you establish a contact between the upper polysilicon layer and the underlying diffusion. Okay, why diffusion? Because source of the upper device and gate of the upper device are shorted. That is established, okay, through this butting buried contact. Okay, so you can take the output from the polysilicon layer. You just extend it a bit and then take a metal contact cut. But one thing you can easily point out, metal always gives the least impedance, right? Here the impedance will be somewhat considerable because the polysilicon impedance is larger than metal. Metal, dear friends, remember, it provides you the smallest value of resistance of the all three conducting layers. Polysilicon and diffusion, they provide definitely much higher impedance. And that also you have seen earlier, no? Undoped polysilicon will give a large impedance, right? So this exercise is just to show that you can do away with the metal cut contact because they will eat up a lot of area, okay? Having to accommodate a thick metal strip inside. Rather than that, if you go for buried contact, then the additional area can be avoided, okay? Next, what we do, dear friends, just may I have your attention to show a small example of how to numerically calculate the salient voltages. So see that for your benefit, I have written all the equations. So VOL, you see, here I'm showing for the values you all feel note down, VDD equal to 5 volt, VTO driver is 1 volt, 0 by threshold voltage, and for the top, it is minus 3 volt, okay. WYL driver is 2 volt, but VTO load, you see, VTO load means this is actually VTO load. You'll be surprised. What is this? Yeah, VTO load means that when the source and body are shorted, but actually source and body are not shorted here, right? So if the source and body were shorted, you would have minus 3 volt. Now that it is no longer shorted, so it will be more positive with respect to minus 3 volt, because you see that when source and body are shorted, you have seen that the threshold voltage becomes more and more positive. So it will be numerically less. That means for minus 3, it may go up to minus 2.8, 2.9, something like that. Let us see. WYL driver ratio 2, WYL load ratio is 1 by 3. Okay.
And this sir, is
the,
sir.
Oh, yes. Yeah.
Sir, sorry. we have a class from 11, actually.
Okay, I'm sorry. Okay, then we'll continue this on Wednesday. Wednesday is a holiday, the Republic Day. So wish you all my heartfelt greetings to all of you and to family members for happy Republic Day. So please enjoy. Then we'll meet on Thursday, I believe, 27 at 10 o'clock we shall meet. Okay, sorry for if I have taken your time. If any doubt, you can ask me. Otherwise, please. Please join your class at 11 o'clock. Okay, thank you, dear friend. If any question is there, he can freely ask me. Or otherwise, please, those who have got classes, please leave for the class. Thank you for your attention, everyone.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.